In this presentation, I will show how you can use the Red Pitaya in combination with the LabVIEW instrument driver for remote control as a measurement and test instrument. My name is Erwin Serlet. I am a Dutch radio amateur, Papa Echo 3, Echo Sierra. We are living in France, where my call sign is Foxtrot 4, Victor Tango, Quebec. In my first Red Pitaya LabVIEW video, I have shown how to fulfill the prerequisites. In this video, we will take a deeper look at the Red Pitaya instrument driver and how we can use that to our advantage. I will show you how to download, install and locate the dedicated Red Pitaya instrument driver, and we will examine its structure and contents. There are a few ways to locate the drivers on the web for download. The main one is the so-called Instrument Drivers Network, which can be found here. It will look like this if you have selected the Red Pitaya board on the first page of that part of the website. We can also find the drivers directly from LabVIEW using the menu Tools command. If you want to find them back on your hard disk, this is the location to look for them, as long as you are using the free community edition of LabVIEW, which is 32 bits. When they are installed and you go to the LabVIEW menu, they will look like this. And you can see that I have a few more instrument drivers installed besides the Red Pitaya instrument driver. When you click this one, you come here. You see a lot of examples made with this instrument driver, but you can also go here, open the palette, and then find the VI tree, which is an important way to understand how the instrument driver is built. So we click the VI tree icon and open it. You can also see which happens after Ctrl H, it's showing the content relevant help. Now we can investigate the building blocks of this instrument driver. It has six subgroups which organize the sub-VIs into different functions: initialize, configure, action and status, data, two utility blocks, and closing the instrument after use. And when you go with your mouse cursor on one of these blocks, like here, you will find the content relevant help. First, we will see how the initialize block is opening the Red Pitaya instrument. It is using one of the standard LabVIEW blocks to open a raw TCP connection to the Red Pitaya. So let's activate our hardware and do a first test. Now that we can be sure the LabVIEW part is working, we can turn our attention to the Red Pitaya board. The board should have a current image on the SD card, here. It should be connected to your network via an Ethernet cable and to the 5V supply. And we will use the interface via the web browser. There we can start under development the Skippy server, and when it is running it shows you the IP address of the Red Pitaya as well as the port number. These details are needed to connect to the Red Pitaya board from within LabVIEW. So now the real life demo can start. We will now open the LabVIEW program and via Tools, Instrumentation, find Instrument Driver. We will locate the Red Pitaya one. As you can see, there are many different drivers available. You will see that you need quite a few steps to find the driver page. Here you find different versions, if there are different versions, for different versions of LabVIEW, also for the next gen, but we will use this one, LabVIEW 2080 upgrade. It downloads a zip file, and the contents of that zip file need to be put on the right place, as I've shown you in one of the previous slides. If you have passed the test, either via the website or in another way to find the Red Pitaya driver, and go to one of the examples. We have to make some adjustments. For instance, pick the right IP address to get access to the instrument. And then we see that when you don't put a real voltage on the pin, it is rather low. And we would like to see the bar graph to work. So we have to change something in the underlying structure. So we open the program. With how big the input information is, you will change the amount to multiply it before we show it on the LEDs. So here we can see that it works on the virtual instrument, but we also want to see how it works on the real instrument. So I made a small movie that's showing that the little LEDs on the board itself are also active as a result of measuring the analog voltage on this analog input. now look into the internals. And open some of the sub-VIs. So a sub-VI also has an instrument panel and a block diagram. Here we see the small utility sub-VI, which, as I said, also has a panel. And when you do Ctrl-E, it will also show the little block diagram where we have the Skippy message going via a raw TCP connection into the Red Pitaya, as seen before. I choose the red analog voltage from the slow analog input as a first example. It presented the result as a true analog voltage, but it also showed it on the LabVIEW instrument display as a lead bar graph. And we have seen that this lead bar graph represents the lead bar on the equipment itself. Now that we have seen the example at work, we can investigate the inner structure. So we click on the sub-VI called setPin, and that opens this underlying structure, which is setting a digital output pin. It consists of a few standard blocks, but also a new sub-VI. And we recognize this new sub-VI from the VI tree as a utility sub-VI, which makes a setting via the raw TCP connection. If we click on that and open it, we can see this underlying structure. Here the raw TCP connection, and here something that we have also seen in the first video. It's creating a Skippy message, including the necessary carriage return line feed to be fed into the equipment. With this example and the background I gave you, you can now use the Red Pitaya LabVIEW instrument driver for your own work. Here are some sources on the internet that can lead to a deeper understanding or help you when you get stuck at some point. There are also many articles, for instance in the Funk Amateur magazine or in Electro magazine, on the Red Pitaya. And if you think you have exhausted the possibilities of using the Red Pitaya with LabVIEW, there is always more to discover. For instance, in programming the field programmable gate array yourself. I hope you enjoyed this short video, and a big thank you for the support given by the Red Pitaya team. Goodbye for now, and hope to see you in one of my next videos.